Civil 851, turn right, heading 180.
The Boeing 787 has re-entered headlines in the past 24 hours, following the aircraft manufacturer receiving a notice from the Federal Aviation Administration. The notice is an urgent one and surrounds an airworthiness directive requiring the inspection of a total of 222 of the 787s, following reports surrounding a new problem that may have been found and needs to be checked. The problem is surrounding the decompression panels on the belly of the aircraft. Specifically though, the panels are separate to that of the passenger compartment, as noted, and strictly center around the cargo compartment of the jet. This hasn't been the first airworthiness directive from the FAA surrounding the Boeing 787 in recent times, and a lot of questions surrounding the quality of the jet, especially with the quality assurance tests, remain to be present, and I guess something like this only adds to those concerns that people were already having surrounding the type. The reports that I mentioned before come from airlines that have noted multiple incidents with the decompression and/or torn components that are now going to undergo a major inspections. The inspections that I speak of will see the FAA and more go around and determine the issue isn't as widespread as potentially it could be. Also, these inspections will help note whether something needs to be replaced or if something just needs to be briefly adjusted, or potentially nothing needs to be changed at all. That is really the beauty and the whole point of these inspections. These inspections are often something we see within the aviation industry on a regular basis, and it doesn't necessarily mean that the problem is, say, severe. That is something I should mention right off the bat. But it is the best course of action, naturally, to address any sort of report that could impact passengers, crew, and ultimately the safety of the aircraft in question, which in this case is the Boeing 787 series. You might also be asking just how these specific decompression panels pose a risk to the aircraft. Well, should there be a fire in the cargo hold specifically, these panels usually would play a crucial role in keeping the fire central and in one position, but also housing all the right components to keep it, well, ultimately, controlled. While it is highly unlikely a cargo hold would catch fire, should it do so on one of these 787s that is reportedly facing these panel issues, the panels would therefore not be adequate enough to do their job and control the fire. While a fire is very far-fetched and not something we see any day and not something we would wish for, it is standard procedure to make sure that this is working properly in the case of absolutely anything extraordinary taking place. At the end of the day, while it might not be something routine, there always is that minimal chance that it could happen, and it is better to be safe rather than sorry, hence the 222 Boeing 787s now set for a routine inspection that is noted as urgent to carry out any fixes that need to be implemented or potentially just regular checks. Production issues have also been found on the Boeing 787 last year, with multiple types being impacted on the assembly line themselves, following non-compliance issues with the horizontal stabilizers. Due to, in addition, the pandemic, the 787 has been impacted, with production consistently decreasing as airlines worldwide don't need these wide-body jets to be delivered to them at the moment, with current restrictions. So if anything, if the type has to be inspected at any point, you could argue now is the best time, all things considering. What are your thoughts? Let me know down below, and I hope you've all been enjoying the content this past week. Please be safe and take care, and I will see you tomorrow for the next video.